So we're back again. We now know the NBA 2K19 Myteam gameplay, and to be honest, I'm probably using one of the best cards in the game in this gameplay. And it's going to be a slept on card, but just trust me. The card is this Pink Diamond 98 overall Dave Cowens. So yes, he's a center. Yes, he's 98 overall. Yes, he's only 6'9". But once you see the stats, your whole opinions will change. Also, if you guys want to see my pack opening that I did earlier today, be sure to click the link in the description. It was absolutely crazy. That's all I'll say. So as I said, he's 6'9". He's 99 on offense, 99 on defense. But before we do that, I'm actually going to go apply shoe and put these foam pursuits on him. I don't even know how to say it. But yeah, let's just chuck these shoes on him to add a 3-ball, and then I can show you stats after this. So when we go into his stats now, he has 99 driving lap, insane post scoring. Pretty much everything is really good. 98 mid-range with the shoe, 92 open shot 3, which will go up to a 96 with my coach. 95 free throw, insane dunking, 91 ball control on a center. Actually, very good passing as well. 98 block, 99 shot contest, 95 steal, 98 across the board for rebounding, 88 speed, which isn't really the best, 82 speed, which is his only little issue with ball, then 93 acceleration, 90 vertical, 95 strength, 98 stamina, 96 lateral quickness, and then all of the defense so far is in 98s or 97s. So this is literally one of the best cards in the game. His dunking tendencies are at 100 for driving and 95 for standing, also 99 for alley-oop. The system proficiencies are perfect except for triangle. And then just to add to it, 19 Hall of Fame badges. 19. Comes with chase down artist, mid-range deadeye, rim protector, pickpocket, difficult shots, pick and popper, defensive stopper, hustle rebounder, tireless scorer, catch and shoot, up and under specialist, lob city finisher, posterizer, drop stepper, acrobat, putback king, pick and roller, relentless finisher, and post spin technician. He also comes with 6 gold badges, but to be honest, none of these are good. And that's why your boy is going to add his own by adding limitless range, deep range deadeye, dimer, corner specialist, pick and roll maestro, because I may as well. And now that they're all gold, this card is going to be so much better. So yeah, this is the team that we're rocking with. I replaced this card for Karl Malone pretty much, because now Blake Griffin's gone to the bench. But to be honest, if his stats stick to the way that I think he's going to play, he might take Karl Malone's spot. There's one more thing I want to show. Dave Cowens versus Andre Kirilenko. So Andre Kirilenko is one of everyone's favorite cards in this game. They're both the same height, but when we look through the stats, just look at how many stats Dave Cowens destroys Andre Kirilenko in. Then you also got to remember, he comes with 19 Hall of Fame badges compared to 0 for AK-47. So this is the squad, and that's the intro. I want to go off with this Dave Cowens. We've only taken 2 losses in this series, and if you watch my channel, you'll know why, but hopefully we can get a win in this game, and hopefully Dave Cowens can absolutely destroy. There's only one way to find out though. Let's get into the game. I didn't even notice, but we found our first opponent. His team is pretty good, but Dave Cowens, it's your time to shine. And our jerseys are kind of similar, but we can tell the difference. And for some reason, I swear, Dave Cowens just looks bigger than 6'9". I don't know if that's just me, but we're just going to try and play defense here. His lateral quickness seems insane. He's got Bob Pettit. That's really bad defense on the first possession. That's on me. Ah, that's a bad pass too. What a start for Dave Cowens. He's got a turnover and also he's been scored on. Really not the best. He's got Kevin Durant there and he's going to try and take a 3 on me, I reckon. He's going to try and little step back. Not that time, as we're playing very nice defense. Maybe a steal there. Just not. Maybe a steal there. Nope. And he's just going to call a pick and roll by the looks of things with that man. And we're going to give it to Dave Cowens. We're going to give it to KD. That's his first assist. Let's go. So yeah, I'm definitely not going to try and go for every single point with this card just because that's going to be a little bit too difficult, as I always find that difficult with cards like this, as we're going to go inside with him here. Let's just go up. And can he make that? Free throws. Now let's check his free throw release. I forgot his free throws. At 95? Yeah, it is. And I mean, with 95, he should really never miss these, as we almost missed that one. You've got the Pink Diamond Michael Jordan. I've got the Galaxy Opal, and we're playing perfect defense against Bob Pettit there. That's actually nice defense right there, and we end up getting the board too. I want Bob Pettit to run this up. No, not Bob Pettit. My boy, Dave Cowens. It's a deep one, but he makes it, and that's base 11 for you. I kept it a secret, but he has base 11. Dude, my defense right now is just looking so good, as we're going to try a little snatch back here, then pull 3. It's a green light, dude. This card's insane. I just can't believe we're actually pulling snatch back 3s with Dave Cowens, who's a center, but he has 91 ball control and like a 96-3 with my coach. Absolutely insane, as he's going to be taking that 3 there. Should make that one, which he does, and we're going to try and run this up once again. with Michael Jordan and then just get the pick and fade to go with Dave Cowens. Going to the right side, kicking it out to him. Probably should have taken that, but we're going out with a layup, as that's a weird animation. I thought he was going to be doing a little bit better than that, but we get the pass out for the midi splash. So we get a steal on the inbound too, and let's just give it to Dave. Pump fake the first, got with the second, and it's wide open, and he's going to miss that one, but we do grab the rebound, and it's a midi and splash. All I will say is there's absolutely no way I'm getting rid of this card. I'm 100% keeping him as we're calling another pick and fade. And I'm telling you, these pick and fades are just so OP as we're going to go down here, but he's got Steph Curry on us, and that's just where the mismatch happens, where we can just go up and get a standing dunk. Giannis actually has a really nice stat line with 3 points, 4 rebounds, and 3 assists. I just like seeing that stat line a lot as he just catches and shoots there on the trail and misses though. I just got to be a little bit more trigger happy with those as they are wide open shots, and we're going to kick it to him here. Get a little snatchback going with the left hand, going up there and getting the dunk. I don't think you guys are going to understand the cheese I'm about to do after this, as we're just going to go up there and jam it on Blake. And I know I'm not going to do this myself, but I thought I should just show it that I am actually running him at point guard right now. I know how cheesy it is. I'm not going to do it myself. As I said, before the gameplay, it's what I do because some people want to do it. So I want to show that it can be done. He makes both free throws. Just kick it to him here. Get a little snatchback. Oh, damn it. I sort of had that three, but look at his dribble moves, and he's getting more free. He's only getting one free throw because it's an N1. I literally do not understand. Makes the free throw too. Need defense from you here, Dave, and that's not going to be a shot for Shaq. So we're just going to play perfect defense there. Grab that rebound, and okay, it's calling for the ball, but I want to kick it to my left. And then, damn it, he could have had an easy score there, but unfortunately, it just wasn't the smartest, but we're going to get an easy score because he's on the drive and it's an easy layup. And he is now hot, but unfortunately, he doesn't have what to do. I don't even know what I'm saying, but he is going to get a dunk here. Jam! All right, Dave, let's run this one up. I sort of want to get more threes with him, but I'm just not able to right now. So we're going to call a pick and roll with Blake, and he should run into the screen. And then I was thinking about taking the three, but we're just going to take that assist. That's just because he's overplaying it. My defense has also been super good just off the back of this man right here. So we're going to get another assist right there. Actually, we're going to miss, but we're going to give it back out to Dave, and it's a wide open three. Splash! Is it bad that I'm really liking him at point guard? Yes. Yes, it is bad, I guess. Okay, let's call it another pick and roll and actually go with the left hand this time. I'm just going to go up. That's really not a good shot, but it's Dave. I really do want to try and get more threes with him, like in transition like that. That would be awesome if I was able to get that, but unfortunately we're not. We are going to get a dunk. It was really slow, but I was gonna make it high. Come on, is this a three? I want to take a deep one. I know it's deep, and I just can't believe this. So, only got 6 seconds left on the clock. We're going against Steph Curry, but the whole thing is, that's just perfect defense, and of course he's going to miss that because we had a center and a center right there, and I'm going to kick it to him. Catch and shoot. That's really not a good shot. What? Oh, baby, let's run this one up. Can I get a snatch back here? And that's actually wide open. That's actually wide open. And the whole thing is I haven't really been able to show it just because he's been passing away from Steph, but our defense has just been perfect as we might be able to get a steal here. Nope, just not, but we are going to be able to put the hand up and look at that. Just, I just can't believe that this is actually a card in 2K. It's able to do everything. And finally, you guys say, I have decided to actually put him at power forward now. And we're just going to pull a three straight away. It's lightly contested. He's going to miss, but we're going to pass it back out to him. Then to KD. That's going to be an assist. Give me that. Use your speed, Dave. Use your speed. And then go up to the... I should have just taken that. I didn't realize that he was actually going to get that animation where it's just a normal standing shot. But we're getting free throws there. Is that goaltending? No. Let's just make both of these. I know he's tired. I'm going to call my timeout soon. And then he'll literally have full energy going into the fourth quarter. Crazy things. And I just got done with calling pretty much all of my timeouts. So now Dave is going to have pretty much full energy to be able to do things just like that. That should be a steal, which it is. And we're going to run up and we're going to get another dunk. And we're going to get another steal. Okay, nice. And we're going to give this one to Giannis. And we're going to take the three. And we're going to get the assist. Nice. And I'm actually going to say this. You guys are not ready for what I'm about to say. This card, in my opinion, is better than Galaxy Opal Bob Pettit. That's just my opinion. As he gets the block of me right there, he was not happy with what I said. But we're going to go up again and get an N1. That's what matters. Now, you might be asking, why do you think this card is better? It's a weird reason.
But he thick.
If you know what I'm saying in 2K, you want players to be chunkier. So I don't know if it's just me, but I just noticed that Bob Pettit really doesn't do much for me just because he's too skinny, as that's just a bad release. And that's the reason we miss, unfortunately. But we're going to kick it back out. Pump fake on that one. Going against Kristaps, going up there, getting free throws once again. He's literally just drawing the free throws pretty much every single time. And he hasn't missed a single one. So it's just an easy 2 points. I really need to make a three from a deep position. And you might be asking, why? For the thumbnail. really just for the thumbnail, I ain't gonna lie. So this is the spot right here. I wanted it to be green, but he's gonna miss that, and we're gonna kick it back to him, and we're gonna go back to the three-point line, and let's just try a little snatchback. He's not expecting that. That's real deep. Can he make it? Damn it, that would have been a good one. Defense here versus Kristaps. I know he's taller, but he had to pass it out, and he's gonna try and take that three. I'm pretty sure not, but we've got Kristaps against us now. But the whole thing is, Dave Cowens is a beast on defense, and you can see that right there. He literally doesn't have anything, and we end up getting the rebound, and we're gonna kick it to him, and we're gonna try a little snatchback, and we're gonna pull the three in transition. Dave Cowens, splash. You guys will not believe it, I'm actually playing him at center right now. You should be very happy with me, very proud, as yeah, that was just not lucky. I can't even speak, but he's inbounding right now. We're gonna kick it back to him. I want to take a deep one for the thumbnail, as it's heavily contested. Yeah, nice. Dave, I need the thumbnail. Come on, make it. Oh, I feel like I might just have to Photoshop the thumbnail, which I know is kind of clickbait, but not really. Because the only thing I really want to show with the card is just that he's insane. So can we please make this? Can we please make this? Come on, Dave, make that one for me. It's near the buzzer. Damn it, he's going to miss that, but we're going to kick it to him. And we're going to go out just a little bit further for the thumbnail from deep, and he's going to miss that. Cool. You've got one more shot, Dave. One more shot. From the logo, Dave Cowens, he's gonna make it. Yes, there's the thumbnail. Thank you. And because I'm feeling like good guy Killsy, I'm gonna give my opponent the win. I really don't need it, so let's just go to settings, go to network, and then just go bam bam, and now he's got the win. But of course, before I did that, I did check his stats. Why didn't I look at them and do it at the same? I don't know why I'm not just reading his stats right now, but it's just because I'm not the smartest. But he did end up getting 62 points. I think he had one rebound and like 5 assists, and he did shoot a very good percentage. I'm actually going to go back with the stats right now to when he had 59 points, and I was just going for those deep threes because I decided to check his stats there just to make sure that, you know, I actually showed off his good efficiency. So his efficiency was just insane, and obviously he was making some insane shots as well. And I love it when I do these types of gameplays and I realize I don't even have to put in a second game. Like, you guys can obviously see this is one of the best cards in the game. So let me compare this card to some people for you. So he's better than Galaxy Opal Bob Pettit. I just have to say that. Is he better than Blake? Yes. Is he better than Karl Malone? Yes. I know they might be Galaxy Opals, but he's literally better than both of them. All of them, actually. Just because he has base 11. Literally, just pretend that this is Galaxy Opal Andrei Kirilenko. It's just because it says Dave Cowens that people are going to think differently. But if you apply the right shoe to him, his three goes up to 92 with the coach to 96. His ball control also goes up to 95 with the coach, that is. And the shoe shot contest 99, excel 93. If only he had a bit more speed with ball, then that would be perfect. But literally, then that would make him like one of the best cards in the game, like probably the second best. Yo, he might like low key might be like the fourth best card in the game. And there's a reason why he's selling for so much. There's also a reason why I actually might sell mine right now and buy him back in a couple of days, as I think that might be a good option. As I know I said there's no way I'm getting rid of this card, but I'm 100% buying him back. And do I recommend him? Yes, I would recommend him for like 600k. Yeah, so there you go. I think the max price I'd pay for this card is 600,000 MT, but he's not gonna go for that much. I reckon he's gonna land at about 300k. So 100% I recommend him. As another thing, he can literally play every single position on the floor, as I need to switch up these two. That's not my team. That's my team, every position. Like, I might actually replace him for Bob Pettit and keep Karl Malone in the backup five. I'm just not too sure, but the whole thing is, he's insane. So yeah, thank you guys for watching this video. Second video of today. I know I didn't get into a second game, but I think you guys can understand why. There was a lot of content in that video, and really, I didn't even notice he got tired. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Your support has been insane recently. If we can keep that up, I'd appreciate it a lot. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. Make sure to smash that like button, subscribe if you're new, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye.